Om Asato Ma Sadgamaya, Tamaso Ma Jyotirgamaya, Mrityor Ma Amrutangamaya, Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi, Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinaha, Sarve Santu Niramayaha, Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu, Ma Kaschid Dukkha Bhag Bhavet. Namaskars to all of you. And namaskars to Venkatesh Murthy and all the members of Youth for Seva of Hyderabad. Nice meeting all of you from the corporate world, from the different NGOs. I understand and I've been connected with Youth for Seva last 5-6 years through different volunteers coming in and out. And this gives me a good chance to meet you and share some thoughts with you, though for a short time. As I understand the different panel discussions that you had since morning and listened to the Honorable Minister and meeting wonderful inspired people like Venkatesh Murthy or Shobhit and others, please keep in mind whatever we do or whatever we give to society, it comes back to you with compound interest. Good, good, bad, bad. Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinaha, it should not be just within your prayer hall or just not in your lips. If you give back to thousands, whether in a traffic jam or whether in an office, end of the day, no stress, no tension, no anxiety. Because meditation is medication. Unless you have the yogic spirit of service, otherwise you land up into roga. In Hindi, we have yoga, roga and bhoga. Too much of enjoyments will make you go to the doctor. And people do a lot of crimes. CBI takes them, puts them charge sheet, and they land up in the central jail and do yogasana there. I keep telling, before, if XYZ had done yoga, why will he be in the central jail? Why will his mind say that this is bad or this is only for me? This is where we are putting the wrong step. We are solving one problem, creating 5 problems. I'll just tell you a story why volunteering and why this kind of seva bhav that we have to develop. End of the day, where is your shock absorber? Is it the government? Is it the corporate world? Is it the banks? Is it the money? Is it the name and fame that you get? Everything gets whitewashed. Everything gets swallowed by nature within seconds. All of us know it, but we don't learn the lessons. Lesson number one, my dear friends, whoever it is from whatever background, let us go back to 1940s, the Second World War. This is my very favorite story and I request all of you to read it at least 10 times because that tonic has to go into the subconscious mind. And then alone a change can come maybe as early as possible tomorrow morning. The book is called Man's Search for Meaning. Look at the title, listen to the title. Man's Search for Meaning. Is there meaning in what I do? Is there meaning in what I talk? Is there meaning in what I live for? And that book is a collection, a first-hand experience of a young doctor by name Viktor Frankl, a Jew, a psychiatrist doctor, working in Vienna in a hospital, and within seconds, whole thing has gone. His whole thing is bombed by the German army. And what does this great man do? Hitler wanted to remove the word Jews from the planet Earth. There should not be any Jews at all. That was his hatred over them. I don't know why he cultivated that attitude, what the poor Jews did to him. So he said, I'll make it extinct. And as we know, as we read in history, gas chambers and mass burials and killings, all that happened, millions and millions, the Holocaust that we know about. But then when we read the book, we know the other side of the Nazi army, where Hitler wanted to spoil or create more mad people in the Jewish community so that the next generation will not be born. And who is the target audience? The youth of Jewish community. He catches all the Jews, what you call, puts them in different places, young, old, medium age, kills them. And these young people, 20 plus, 25 plus, working, strong, future generation, not yet married or just married, he will take them to Auschwitz concentration camp. And Auschwitz was the most notorious concentration camp in the Jewish army. And these fellows are put, no communication, no reading, no external news. What happened to their family? Nobody knows. They have to remain one chained to the other like animals. And there are beautiful pictures, very painful pictures, where it's not even a cell, it's a cage, where they have to crawl in to lie down and come out when the bugle is sounded. This is going on for 3-4 years. And slowly people are becoming mad or they are shot dead. Thanks to Viktor Frankl, where his study habit, his education, saved him at that crucial moment of life. Reading was banned, news was banned, communication was banned. How will you live? What will happen to the brain? What will happen to the body? Where is the stimulation? Where is the purpose? And stale food is given, nutrition is cut off, and brain cells becoming weaker and weaker. They have to work under minus 40 degree temperature, go naked sometimes, take the pickaxe and break the ice through where the railway tracks were put. These all the work they were doing. Luckily or fortunately, a small piece of newspaper comes flying near the prison of these Jews. A small cutout newspaper piece. Viktor Frankl picks it up, hides it in his pocket, because they are not allowed to read. If somebody sees them read, he will be shot dead or he will be thrown into the dungeon. He hides it, and in the late night, in the dim light of the prison, this guy is reading that piece of newspaper. Can you guess for how many days, a day, 2, 4, 5, same piece of newspaper, nothing else he got. He kept on reading that newspaper matter, few columns, till Germany was defeated by Russia. Nearly 4.5 years. Kept on reading that same piece of newspaper and started thinking differently. Stimulated the brain cells. And finally Russia defeated Germany. Hitler is dead. And what is that tragedy there? There comes the question of existence. Your very life is at stake. Why should I live? Why should you live? Why this conference? Why this conclave? Why this seva? This is where you educated people have to think based on that lesson, man's search for meaning. When Russian army comes and opens all the cells, all the jails, hundreds and hundreds, you know who they were? Literally mad people. Hundreds of them. Shocking, very painful story. And then they open the rooms, costly garments, piled up for the sake of the Nazi army. And they can use it. They can take whatever they want. But their mind is not there. You know what the Jews guys do, youth do? They go and destroy it. Put fire to it. Tear it. Isn't it shocking mindset? When everything is there, mind is not there, my dear friends. And then open another door, another room. Costly food, fruit, drinks, whatever you want. They have no mind to eat. They go and destroy it. Crops they are destroying. Food they are destroying. Clothes they are destroying. They destroy themselves. They become a burden for themselves. Very sad story. And finally psychiatrists come, mental ambulances come, take them all to the reformatories, take them to the asylums. This Viktor Frankl goes back to Vienna. 27-year-old guy. What does he see? Mass destruction. Mass bombing. Hospital is bombed. Where will he work? Hundreds of patients. Hundreds of poor people on the streets of Austria. He feels, let me do something to my brethren, to my friends, to my colleagues, to my citizens, to my Jewish community. My dear friends, he sits on the footpath with a broken chair and table and starts his service. Starts counseling. First thing is, we want to die, we want to die, we want to die. Nothing is there. Nothing is there. In Hyderabad we say, Bahar Sharwani, Andar Pareshani. Whole thing is crying inside, suffering inside, Bahar Sharwani Painta. Show masters. And this man says, why should you die? The United Nations will come, allied forces will come. They'll give you some facilities, they'll give you some loan, start life. No. Rivers are full of dead bodies. Wells are full of dead bodies. Poison is sold rampantly. Then he changes his therapy, changes his methodology of treating patients and serving the patients. When I say you don't die, you say you die and you go. And now if somebody comes, very humorous also, he says, you say, I want to die. Viktor Frankl says, now go and die. Here is a rope. Here is a rope. Here is poison. He gives them. The moment he gives them, they say, who are you to tell that I should die? I won't die. I will live. Sit down. Now I'll tell why you should leave. That's how he changes his methodology, changes his style of medication, changes his style of counseling. He saves another thousands. There's a funny story where he's walking on river bank. A lady is being washed out. She's crying for help. And he puts a rope, he puts something, takes the help of the villagers, brings her out, gives her coffee, gives her warm clothing, gives her something. After just 15 minutes, she starts crying and crying and crying, unconsolable. My dear friends, he says, my dear sister, you are saved. You are drowning. You are being carried away in the water. But you are shouting for help. Why are you crying? She says, I want to die. A peculiar situation. You are crying for help. And that lady argues. She says, I was crying for help. Does it mean that you should save me? Paradox. And she is going to the river to die. You see, in life, when death comes, you are afraid. Otherwise, you are a hero. I want to die. This is an existential question today. I keep telling my volunteers, I keep telling the students who come to Ramakrishna Math Human Excellence, if something happens in HiTec City tomorrow, signals are off, Donald Trump closes his door to Hyderabad, is there any lifeline for you? Kaun banega crorepati? What will you do? Where is your lifeline? Where is your atmabalam? Tons and tons of chaos. UNESCO says, young India's problem or future India's problem will not be Alzheimer's disease. It will not be AIDS. It will not be dengue. It will not be unemployment also. A strange suffering we have to undergo, that of young, rich, retired Indians. Millions of them will be there in future. Young, rich, retired Indians. At 40 retired. Tons of money in the bank. Where he will go? Either to a psychiatrist or to a pub. No seva, no yoga. He has not thought of it. And finally, he becomes a burden to himself. Service is such a weapon. Karma yoga is such a weapon. I was browsing through the book of the great economist, Shoemaker, who wrote a book called Small is Beautiful. Where he categorically says, the generosity of the earth, I repeat, the generosity of the earth allows to feed all mankind. Is there food less in India? Is there no, what you call the food distribution department, the government, the FDI, FCIs, Food Corporation of India? But do you know the fact? In Madhya Pradesh, the center of India, and called the Madhya Desha of the Holkars, of the Ahalya Bhais, every day, 0 to 6 years, tiny babies are dying out of starvation. Not out of malnutrition, they are dying of starvation when tons and tons of money are in FCI godowns. Can you imagine? A mother, instead of taking her child to the school, is taking that baby to the graveyard. Does it make you sleepless? Swami Vivekananda referred to this point and said, we gave ditch water when Ganga is flowing by. Next door neighbor has become a brute and we are enjoying his meal. This is a sin on the great nation, he says. In another place, very pathetically writes a letter from America to Madras, the emblem of the Divine Mother. The emblem of the Divine Mother who is worshipped from Kashmir to Kanyakumari in India has become a beast of burden only to bear children, life itself a curse in India. The woman is an embodiment of sex, embodiment of just enjoyments in this great Punya Bhumi. We have Bhadrakali in Hamakonda. We have Vijayawada Kanakadurga. We have Kanchi Kamakshi, Madurai Meenakshi. And that woman has been insulted left, right, center in the form of trafficking, in the form of all sorts of malpractices. There you see what Shoemaker says in reference to the economy of the nation. We have enough about ecology to keep the earth a healthy place. Enough room on the earth. Enough room on the earth. Enough materials, adequate shelter, quite competent to produce supplies. No economic problem at all. But there is a moral problem. This is Shoemaker, the economist in the book Small is Beautiful. There's a moral problem. And what is the moral problem? Self-centeredness, selfishness. This science cannot remove it. Your IT cannot remove it. Your industry cannot remove it. But today we need a cultural and a spiritual transformation. Today there is a fear of narcissism in the youth of India. Falling in love with oneself. As narcissist saw his own reflection and he pined himself to death. He pined himself to death because he's not getting love of himself. This is a serious psychological pressure on the youth of India today. Otherwise, an IIT boy, third year in Hyderabad, will not jump from the third floor of a building telling at 20 years his life has no meaning. And this is across our neighbor. A third year engineering boy says, life has no meaning for me at the age of 20. I kept telling in our meetings in the volunteer, that fellow should have gone to Madhya Pradesh and served if there was no meaning. He will understand what the life is. He would have gone to Chhattisgarh and worked with the tribals in the Naxalite area of Abujamar, of Bastar, of other places with 60% Naxalism. One of my students, a company secretary, earning 1 lakh rupees call letter from a big company, from an MNC, 1 lakh. The day he heard me telling, join Teach for India, he joined by tearing off that letter. Got more inspiration, seeing the suffering pathetic in Bhavanpalli in Secunderabad. Now that guy has plunged himself into education for the villagers of India. And I'm talking in Hyderabad, in this fantastic AC auditorium, AC room for a conclave. But they're right there in Chhattisgarh, in Abujamar district, in Bastar. He gives a painful experience which I am going to share with you, which you should think and probe after this conclave. It should become part of your digestive system. It pains me when I tell this story. An 8th standard boy has not been coming to school for 5 days. Where is he? What is he doing? It's not possible to identify or to go behind. No proper communication in the forest areas. 7th day he comes, next Monday he comes back. To the shock and surprise of his group, of the teachers and the people, his shirt that he is wearing is stinking blood. It is blood, netturu, not color of red, it is blood. And the smell of blood is creating nausea in the classroom. He is sitting in the corner with a fearful face. 8th standard boy, our own younger brother of India. When we say sarve bhavantu sukhinah, he also matters. As much as my hair matters here. And this guy by name, one of our volunteer goes and requests him. What happened? What happened? Why didn't you come 5 days, 6 days? No answer. They take him out because of the nauseatic smell of blood. They take him to the principal's room, give him a shirt, wash him, give him some water, give him some food. He's so terrific to look at. My dear friends. And only one word is coming from his mouth. Usko mar diya, usko mar diya. Usko mar diya, usko mar. Kya, kisko mar diya re? Usko mar diya. He is full of that intoxication. Usko mar diya. Kisko mar diya. They probed a little. One to one. Now hold your heart in your hand. That 8th standard boy says, mera baap ko mar diya. Mera baap ko mar diya. This is the condition there. Why and how? That's a different matter. An 8th standard boy has killed his own father. When we speak of Seva, when we speak of this weekend volunteering, what are we doing? Do you feel? Do you feel? Do you feel? Do you need always certificates? Do you need a utility badge? If your mother is in ICU, will you just say, I will come only on Sunday? If the mother is having diagnosed with cancer, will you guys say of the corporate world that you are only in, will you meet her only next Monday and pay 5 lakhs in Paytm? No, I don't think so. That is the condition of our motherland today. This was the heart with which Vivekananda cried on September 11, 1893 when the whole world was open to him. How many of you know the story? Within 3 minutes, man becomes famous. Whole America is in his hands. They're sitting at the feet of this monk who is 30 years. And Aurobindo says, Vivekananda could have become the president of the whole world if he desired. Europe was in his fist. English people were listening to him. They're sitting on the ground, meditating on the Om in London. And when we are being kicked by the British Samrajya in India, France was at his feet. Switzerland was at his feet. Whole India roused itself to higher consciousness. Vivekananda says, gutter called name, gutter called fame. I have not come for these enjoyments. I have come for the millions of the brothers, sisters who are suffering without food and shelter. 11th September, he could not sleep. He was seeing through the east in Chicago in a big palatial house and cried whole night. Oh mother, when you are in the streets, I am enjoying this. That's how a monk becomes a nation builder. How many minds he did not inspire. Whether it is Tata's, it is because of Vivekananda. The IISc in Bangalore is because of Vivekananda. His brainchild, do something for the youth of India, otherwise they will go away. Do some research. Hold them back. That's how IISc came. Tata Institute of Fundamental Research came. That's why Venkatesh Murthy came. That's why Babar Ali in Bengal came. That's why Parivar in Madhya Pradesh, by name Vinayak Lohani, after finishing his IIM Kolkata, came. Sharad Babu in Nellore, last 50 years he is doing a Vivekananda Seva, without a brochure also for his institute called Child Ashram. I visited Child Ashram. Some of you should visit Nellore just overnight. 30 kilometers from Nellore, go. It's a divine, it's called Child Ashram. He doesn't call it orphanage. And who are the children? Children who are caught by the police in chain snatching, in chain robbery, train robbery. Petite, small children. They are beaten, abused. Children whose parents are in prison for some reason. Parents are life imprisonment. They are a stigma on the society. Children whose parents have died out of AIDS. They are a stigma to society. Children who are raped or abused. Girls who are raped or abused by the police, etc. Stigma on the society. Children whose parents have died of accident, this fellow is left out. There's a problem in the society. They become criminals. All of them he takes care. Last 40 years he is doing Nirantara Seva. Without a brochure, without a conference. He is now 58. He started when he was 18 years old. Miracles and miracles. You may call it intuition. You may call it God's grace. You may call it coincidence. Name it. But the reality is, Vivekananda is there in his ashram. He started with one room. Today, government has given him 32 acres. One incident I will tell and close. My dear friends, a boy who was brought by the police from Nellore railway station, triple murder, juvenile, triple murder. He killed 3 people because his mother and father were kidnapped and he was made a guinea pig. Kill, otherwise we will kill your parents. So he killed 3 people. And he attempted to kill this Sharad Babu also by putting something over the fan, a bomb over the fan. Tremendous intelligence, but misguided missile. Somehow by God's grace, Sharad Babu Garu was saved. Life transformation is seva. Not just a charity. Not just a donation. Not just in going to an orphanage or your anniversary or birthday. No. That is social help. Vivekananda says, remove the word help from your dictionary. Who are you to help? Are you Lord God? You can only serve, serve, serve the children of God. This man did it. That boy, triple murder, life transformed. And you know where he is? He is somewhere in this part, in the what you call home guards of Kondapur. He is on promotion as a police officer. Triple murder boy is a police officer in home guards station in Gachibowli area. He brought him to me, to Ramakrishna Math, because I was hearing about him. Slowly he came to my ears and said, Swamiji, this is that fellow who tried to kill me and had already killed 3 people. Late because of juvenile, this one, they released him on parole and now he is in the home guards. He is a police officer. Look at the transformation. Look at the metamorphosis. Look at the change maker. A reality in life. It's not in heaven. It's not in books. So my dear friends, 3H formula we follow in human excellence, which I share and close. Other part of the program is there. Head to think, okay, intelligence, creativity, innovation, everything is fine. There's no dearth of it today in India. If you have a head to think, have a heart to feel. And if you have a heart to feel, find out the real solutions for the burning problems of the country. Hands to work. Head to think, heart to feel, hands to work. But the second one becomes your priority. If you don't feel, you won't think also. The day you are having stomach infection, the day you are having diarrhea or dysentery, I give you the best Hyderabad biryani. Will you eat? It is sheer poison for you. You will say, no. I say, you like it, man. No, no, no. You will push it off because that is poison for you on the given day. You don't feel. So that feeling has to be roused. That is where sensitivity comes. It's not empathy also that we want. It's not sympathy. It's not Venkata Chalapati that we want. It is the real feeling. Unless that feeling is roused, or it is time for our nation, for our society to have feeling. Tons and tons of money. The QNET scam of 5,000 crores of HiTec City. Is it a small amount? You could have purchased America tomorrow. 8,000 crore scam of PMC. Going into few pockets. Few selfish people. Nation barbaad ho sakta hai. That's why Seva comes inside. Karma Yoga comes inside. Because it takes you to a high level of spiritual excellence. You will grow inside out. It's a great blessing to us. That is where we find a beautiful bhajan which we sing. A 17th century poet writes about Seva. Hindi bhajan, it says, Chetan Dev ki seva karo, janm safal ho jai. Prema pushp se poojan ki jai, man deepak dar dhyana vicharo. Hirde andar mandir mahi, jagmag jyot jage ujiyaro. Ghat ghat pooran yek niranjan, dvait bhav sab dur nivaro. Chetan Dev ki seva karo, janm safal ho jai. Vivekananda used to sing this song and liked it very much and said, here is the living God. Here is a living God. It cannot be a part-time business. So we have to work on these positives. Work on this Chetana Dev. A living God has come. Your mother has come. Just have that hypothetical attitude. When you go home, your mother is not there. She is not responding to your call. She is not responding to your cry. What will happen to you? You feel upset. Go back to your school days when you rushed home and said your mother is missing. But you know mother is there. Vibrations are there, right? You search this room, that room. Finally, mother is in the bedroom, lying down. This is my very famous, very favorite idea that I am sharing with you. And then you call, go near the bedroom of the mother. It is half closed. Amma, amma, kya hua? Maa ji, kya hua? Ye mahinde neko. And to the shock, you find your mother who was sleeping towards the door suddenly turns the other side and sleeps. She doesn't like to see your face. Another shock for you? You agree with me? Another shock for you? First she did not respond. Now she is there in the house lying down. And as you enter, she is turning the other side. As if you have done a great mistake. you go nearer. Why your mother turned the other side? Think about it, visualize it, be a painter for one minute. Your mother is controlling her tears. Your mother is controlling her tears. She's sobbing. She's emotionally shaken. Something has gone wrong. And you know that there is something there. Your mother does not want you to feel that because you are her beloved daughter's son. She is holding her heart. Now you know that she is sick, that she is crying. My dear friends, young or old, just when you are in school or college, you went and found this situation, will you go and open your Facebook account? Or a TV or call a friend and go for a movie? No, I don't think so. Will you not sit by the side of your mother? Can I get some nodding of the head? Otherwise, I'm talking to statues in Tang Bun. Sorry. Your mother is there crying and you'll sit by the side of your mother, right? Your mother says, pushes you. No, go, velipo. Doramo, will you go away? Such heartlessness. Is it your problem that you did something wrong? Check it, correct it. Be a good son. Is it something regarding your health? Call the doctor. Is it something that happened to father in the office? Find it out. Some bad news from neighbors, from relatives? Check it out. Possible. Then you find a solution. Now please, for heaven's sake, for just one more minute, if I can take, calculate that agony, the pain of your mother, if it is 1,000 units, please calculate it by 38 times. 38 times. How much is it? 38,000 units of heaviness. Why 38? I'm specific. Why not 24? Why not 29? My dear friends, 28 states called Mother India and 10 union territories. That mother is crying today. That mother is crying today. Do you feel that? This is where Seva comes inside. Mother is as much as in Kashmir, as much as in Kanyakumari. She's as much as in Gachibowli, in HiTec City, as much as in Domalguda. As much as in Pune, as much as in New Delhi, Rashtrapati Bhavan. That mother is crying today. And it is our duty, not just a duty, our seva, to that universal mother who lived for thousands of years. But today, for some mistake, water is entering into the ship. Put that mother into a ship, a huge ship of thousands of years. And we are criticizing that ship. We are cursing that ship today. It has become a fashion of the educated people in the media to say all that past of India is rotten. That means your grandfather is a mad fellow. Your grandmother is a fool in the villages who lived that culture of seva, who gave her blood to the villagers. They are all mad, is it? We have to change the tide, and that is why this youth for seva, that's why this interaction and discussions and deliberations from morning till evening, it should not end on Friday. Should enter into our everyday life. All of you, take a pledge in your own heart, as Shobhit rightly put it. Make a metamorphosis of a caterpillar becoming a butterfly, of churning the curd into butter, which will be multi-purpose, useful for everybody. Let us work on those positives. So many examples I can give, live examples here and now, but since it's just a formal meeting, I've just shared some thoughts, have a program. I can suggest to Venkatesh Murthy and all other new people whom I'm meeting for the first time today, the Institute of Human Excellence is open for you. I've suggested a course for Venkatesh Murthy just a few minutes back, which I shall share with you quickly. It's a wonderful course of becoming a contributor for nation development. It is not a consumer only. It's not employed in an IT company only. We need contributors by thousands. Contributors in Delhi, contributors in Hyderabad, become a contributor. Today it's only, I want a mango, okay, but brother, please put some water also. Only I want, let the devil take the hindmost. Any society, psychologically speaking, will have four kinds of people, Africa or Adilabad, Hyderabad or Hollywood. The first category is Satpurushaha. You can count them today. Satpurushaha Paratha Katagaha Swarthan Parityajaye Bhartriharin is Niti Shataka. Swarthan Parityajaye, their head to foot is for others. Count them, countable nouns. My strong minority. Second is Samanyaha, wonderful people. Live and let live. I will give 10 rupees, you give me 19 rupees. Chale telta hai, okay. Live and let live. Samanyaha. But today, the third category is raising their head. That is called the Manava Rakshasaha. How do you define it? What is the concept of Rakshasa? In old NTR films and Mahabharatas, we saw, no? Thaw with the horns and the crow, claws and teeth coming, ha, ho, I will eat you up. Today, nothing else. All that corruption is done by that class of people. It's not the beggar or not the farmer in the villages. Manava Rakshasaha. Somebody humorously put it, please don't misunderstand me. Today, Manava Rakshasa have become suited, coated and booted. Only I. Okay, Baba, I, okay. No. What is yours also is for me. There lies encroachment. Corruption comes in. I for myself. No. What is yours also is myself. Okay. No, still more. You are also for myself. This is where education, training, human excellence. You may have computer excellence. You may have ISB business excellence. You may be IIM Ahmedabad earning 5 lakhs. Human excellence is what you should aim at. That will flow like Ganga. That will flow like Krishna. That will flow into the ocean and make India bright and peaceful for the good of the whole world. Thank you very much. Wish you all the best in your life, in your career. Thank you.